In the previous video, we showed the general shape of the functions y is equal to sine of x and y is equal to cosine of x. In this video, we shall go back to graphing those functions, but we shall do it by plotting points. So this is the unit circle we had been working on ever since we began circular functions. So imagine that this is our unit circle centered at the origin. And what is this table? This table is the reference table. It contains, okay, so the first row contains our special angles. So this will serve us the reference angles when we are evaluating circular functions. And the information in the second row is the endpoint. Okay, so the corresponding point for each of these arcs with lengths t. So you don't have to memorize this big table for the values of your circular functions. Just remember that given the reference angle or given t, sine is the second coordinate of this corresponding point. This is the endpoint of your arc, okay? So sine of pi over 6 is the second coordinate. So it's going to be 1/2. Cosine of pi over 3 is the first coordinate of the terminal point of that arc. And that's a 1/2 again. You don't have to memorize really this big table wherein you have the values for your sine, cosine, tangent, and cotangent. So let's say, for example, you are looking for a second of pi over 3. Okay. Well, if you can memorize them, that would be nice. But if you have this, some kind of an aversion towards memorization, just remember what is the sine and what is the cosine and what is the relationship between secant and cosine. So let's say, for example, secant of pi over 3. Secant is the reciprocal of cosine. Okay, so secant of pi over 3 is the reciprocal of 1/2, which is 2. So we shall begin by plotting points. So let us begin when our angle is 0. What is sine of 0? Okay, look at that. Look at the second coordinate. It is 0. And that is our point. After 0, let us go to pi over 6. When t is equal to pi over 6, our sine is 1/2. So we will plot the points pi over 6, 1/2. Where is that? Okay, this one. So imagine that this, the x coordinate of this point f is pi over 6. So you can imagine a vertical line intersecting pi over 6 here and a horizontal line intersecting 1/2 in our vertical axis. How about when our angle is pi over 4? Okay, look at that. Again, pay attention to the second coordinate. It's square root of 2 over 2. And where's that? Where's that in our plane? That's it. Let's go on. How about when our angle is pi over 3. So sine of pi over 3 is that, the second coordinate, square root of 3 over 2. When x is pi over 2, sine of pi over 2 is that one, that's equal to 1. Let us jump into pi, okay? Let's jump into pi. When x is pi, so the reference angle is going to be 0. So sine of pi is 0. Let us jump into 3 pi over 2. Look at this. This is 3 pi over 2. Our reference angle for that is pi over 2. But it's going to be negative because it's below the horizontal axis. It's going to be negative 1. And then let us go to 2 pi. Again, we shall return to the horizontal axis. It's equal to 0. So you don't have to trace so many points. You know, there is symmetry among these points. So you trace a nice gentle curve. That is the graph of y is equal to sine of x. Okay, so I will now remove this. We shall now produce the graph for your cosine function by tracing some points. So let us begin with x is 0. Our angle is 0 radians. Cosine of 0 is the first coordinate. And so where is that point? If we were to plot that point, that's going to be this one. Point M. 0, x is 0, and y is 1. Let us jump to pi over 2. Look at that. When x is pi over 2, cosine of pi over 2 is 0. When x is pi, our reference angle is again 0. But pi is to the left of your horizontal axis, so it's going to be negative. So it's negative. Look at that. This is the corresponding point. So it's going to be negative 1. Let's show it. When x is 3 pi over 2, again, our reference angle is pi over 2. Cosine of 3 pi over 2 is, look at that, it's 0. And then when we return to 2 pi, okay, our reference angle for that is 0. And our terminal point is to the right of your origin. This is on the positive side of your horizontal axis. So it's going to be positive 1. Okay, and then what you do now is you trace a smooth continuous curve, which is y is equal to cosine of x.